I have another pumpkin. This one is small, as you can see. It's a pumpkin pie pumpkin, and I'm not gonna make a pumpkin pie. This time I am going to try a savory recipe. Since it's pretty small, I don't think it would make that much puree. So I'm gonna cut it open, cut it into chunks, and we are going to try a roast chicken with pumpkin dish, and I will link the recipe down below. I cut the pumpkin open. As you can see, there's lots of pumpkin seeds, and you know I'm gonna keep all these seeds. So I'm gonna clean out the guts, rinse the seeds and dry them and save them for to roast them on a different day. Pumpkin seeds are high in nutrition. They're definitely a health food snack. So don't waste them by throwing them away. Roast them. Anyway, let me get these cleaned out. All right, I cleaned out the inside of the pumpkin. I cut it in more manageable slices. So I'm peeling the outside just with a knife and then cut them into bite-sized chunks. Here is the pumpkin all chunked up. Definitely think this is more than enough for the two of us. So I'm gonna split it into two and just find a different recipe to roast pumpkin tomorrow. I got this recipe from nourisheveryday.com and I will link it down below, but I'm not following it exactly. As I'm reading through it, she used like bone-in chicken with skin, which takes longer to cook because this recipe calls to cook this for 60 minutes. I have two chicken breasts, no bone, no skin. That takes about 30 minutes at 375 degrees. And she used one whole clove of garlic broken up. I have two that is about ready to go bad, so I'm gonna use two heads of garlic. I'm sorry, she said one head of garlic. I'm using two heads of garlic. Everything else is the same, except I'm using two chicken breasts instead of she used bone-in skin and chicken. So that means I'm only gonna be doing 30 minutes, 375. My pumpkin pieces are cut a lot smaller than hers, so that means they will cook quicker. And everything else is pretty much the same. So I'm just gonna whisk together virgin olive oil, balsamic vinegar, honey, coat everything in that, salt and pepper it, put sprinkle sage on the top, and then bake it for 30 minutes. Here is everything mixed together. There's a chicken breast. There's a chicken breast. It's kind of hard to see because they're covered with the pumpkin and the onions. So now I'm gonna bake it at 375 for 30 minutes. Here are the pumpkin seeds from the pumpkin. You need to spread them out on a towel so they can dry. Do not store them until they are completely dry. If you're not gonna use them right away, definitely make sure they're completely dry before storing them, because if there's any moisture in them at all, they will mold very quickly if you put them in an airtight container. So just take a white towel and spread them out and let them dry. About 24 hours to be on the safe side. This is 30 minutes in the oven. Let me see if the pumpkin, it's still a little hard. Let's see what the chicken looks like. They're pretty big breasts. I'm gonna give it 10 more minutes. All right, slight change of plans. I don't want to overcook my chicken breasts. So I pulled it out, I'm gonna let it rest for 10 minutes. I am going to cover this with aluminum foil. And like I said, let it rest for 10 minutes and then cook the potatoes longer. I did take a bite of a small one, I'm sorry, pumpkin. Yeah, it's still a little more crunchy than I would like. So, I think you're supposed to let your chicken rest anyway for the juices to flow nice and juicy. I also made some chicken flavored rice-a-roni for my husband because I'm pretty sure he's not gonna like the roasted pumpkin and he needs a side item to go with his chicken. All right, I cooked it for 10 more minutes. You don't wanna mush, but you don't want them undercooked. So you want the fork to go in pretty easily, and it's going in, I mean, not pretty easily. It's cooked. I could definitely cook it a little longer, but I tasted a couple and they taste really good to me. So, and then the onions are definitely done, and then the garlic. I left the skin on, so when we eat the garlic, we just gotta squeeze it out of the skin. All right, so here we go. Roasted pumpkin with onion and garlic and sage. I'm gonna take a bite of the roasted pumpkin real quick before we sit down. I really like it. It could be cooked a little longer, but I just don't know, like, if you expect it to be soft like a baked potato, but it's not soft. But if you like it crunchy like a vegetable, it's good. You don't have to, you can be honest, you don't like it.
Weird.
You don't like it. I'm glad I made the rice.
It doesn't even like taste like, I was thinking it might taste like sweet potato, or it might taste like a squash, but it doesn't taste like either.
Because pumpkin's a very unique flavor, especially when you eat
it
savory.
That's such a good pie.
I don't know. I do like the sweeter version. I'm eating it. I like it.
You keep eating it.
I like the spices. All right, I want to taste the chicken real quick too. That's really good. I don't cook a lot with sage, so that wouldn't have been my first choice, but it's actually really good. Robert just sprinkled brown sugar on his roasted pumpkin.
Hope that tastes better.
I knew he wouldn't like it. I'm so sorry, Robert.
Okay.
The chicken's good though. Overall, I really like it. You can do the same recipe just with potatoes. For your husband who doesn't like pumpkin. Why is that?
Because he was particular. He only likes things a certain way. And he just, anything outside of that, he was like, no. I turned it into
a very good recipe. Try the chicken. You're going to love it.
I will.